Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue our Eden streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth series. Thank you everybody for the support. We are doing pretty good so far, sitting at 19. It's not the longest Eden streak I've had so far, but it's starting to get a little respectable. I think 19's pretty good. And we've got ourselves a nightmare start here. Oh man, here we go. Hotel X-Ray 1 Sierra 89. UM ever. So, this is the... And we also, by the way, started with the Mitre, as well as no Trinket. But this is going to come down to Mitre hopefully carrying us our way here. Now, we do have decent damage that I can see anyway. What was our stats, by the way? Yeah, we got decent damage. I was going to say our movement speed seems pretty decent, too. So, why is this Nightmare start? Well, as you could probably guess, we only have literally 1 HP. Which means that we're basically one champion hit away, or I guess technically two double mega troll bombs away from dying. And that would obviously not be, let's say it's suboptimal for expectations here. Now we do have to be very careful with this champion torso over here on the right. And what the Mitre will do is the Mitre will turn all non-Soul Heart drops into Soul Hearts, like Red Hearts, for example. Assuming that we're able to hopefully get something. That was terrible. PhD might be okay. We just need to get HP. HP is all we want. Speed up is fantastic. Of course, everyone knows I'm a big stickler for movement speed in Isaac. And right now, we're just going to have to kind of... The clinch is on. I mean, realistically, we are basically Judas right now. But Judas with a... Judas with a big downside in the fact that we don't have the Book of Belial to carry us through the damage. But again, our damage is still decent. I'm almost tempted, actually, to use this key to go into the store so we can buy either a bomb or maybe a half-price Soul Heart. We're kind of desperate right now. There's not a half-price Soul Heart in here. There's not even a Soul Heart, period. There's a pill, however, but no bomb. And... the reason why I was looking for a bomb is because obviously I want to get that Tinted Rock, and then we have to hope that there's a Soul Heart that drops. Basically, we need to do anything that we can right now to get off of 1 HP. That's where the urgency lies right there. And that was the most amazing spider move I think I've ever seen in my life ever. So yeah, the clench is definitely on. And I don't trust spiders around corners either anymore. They have this weird tendency to go through corners and rocks and sometimes even over them. Right, so we got another key. And we did not, unfortunately, get a bomb. A bomb would be great. That's all we want. Obviously, going back here and grabbing this heart is something that we just have to do. Pretty thankful that it did drop over here. But I'm not too pleased with the fact that spider actually hit us. I thought I was laying into him pretty good, but apparently not. Obviously, of course, we are also on the cellar, so this is going to be a kind of a dangerous situation with the Haunt. If we do have to fight the Haunt on 1 HP, we can do it, but I'm not going to be happy doing it. So, we're sitting at 6 cents right now. That's enough to buy that pill, and then we can probably hope maybe that it is a Balls of Steel pill. Again, we do have PhD. Which doesn't necessarily help us right now, but again, we're basically one Balls of Steel pill away. Or even like even Bombs or Key, that would be nice as well. So this is pretty much what I didn't want to have to do, is go into the big room. And especially with the corn flies. This is pretty bad. And then I have to kind of hope that our speed and our damage is going to carry us through here. And if we end up not getting a bomb here, we have to go buy that heart in the store and then pray that it's some sort of HP up or really anything here. We didn't get any drop. And this is about as much danger as the streak has ever been in. You're looking at it right now. So we know that we can go get that heart out of the shop. The real question is, do we buy the pill and take a gamble on it being something that's like Balls of Steel? Or do we take the... Well, I guess we can buy both of them, so we're just going to have to do that. So we're going to buy that and hope that this pill is good. And it's Balls of Steel, if you can believe it! Oh my goodness, that's got to be one of the biggest Hail Marys I think I've ever seen in Isaac, period. And this is actually a terrible room to be fighting Pin in. Pin isn't inherently bad to fight. However, in this room, I mean, obviously, I'd still prefer to fight this over the Haunt, but this would have been nerve-wracking as all hell if we did not get that Balls of Steel pill. But can we just go back and talk for a moment about how much of a miracle that was? I have never, and we didn't even get HP off of Pin either. I've never, yeah, we're not going to go to the curse room. I've never seen a bigger Hail Mary than that right there. I mean, I honestly, if it came down to buying the heart or the pill, I would have actually, I would have bought the heart. I would not have gambled that on that. Oh man, and now we finally get bombs, and there's sad bombs of that, so we are okay now. Now, like, everything seems easy now. It's like, man, I don't know what we were even worried about. So the clench is over, we end up getting synth oil, which of course is great. Damage and range, and we are feeling good now. We can all breathe a sigh of relief. It's not a one run, of course. Don't ever think it's a one run. However, I will say that obviously the heart palpitations are going to subside here. I don't think there's any way that we can get this chest and that key. I'm gonna try, but I don't think so. Yeah, there is. All right. Not too bad. We ended up getting another bomb anyway, so I'm gonna go back and open up this golden chest here. And we get a soul heart, half red heart, and some coins. By the way, we have the wooden penny or the wooden nickel up. I don't remember which one it is. And there you go. There's Miter kicking in. So now we are definitely taken care of. This why the soul heart is huge is because of the simple fact that we do have a very good shot at getting a deal with the devil on this floor. And if we end up getting a deal with the devil, it's going to cost us one red heart and then three soul hearts if we want both of them, assuming it's something that we actually want. So making sure that we have one soul heart left over obviously is going to be good. Now, that being said, that doesn't mean that I may not necessarily be willing to put ourselves in harm's way again. I've been known to do that, where I've gone a little bit too ham on a trade-in for a deal with the devil, and then come to find out that it wasn't really the best idea. Now, the soul converter here is it's actually really, really important. So what the soul converter will do is it will take two soul hearts and turn them into one red heart. So I'm going to do that right now. And in fact, I'll probably do it one more time here. That way, we just converted all of our soul hearts into red hearts. And that way, we don't have to worry about paying three hearts for a deal with the devil, whereas we can only just simply do it for, well, we just did it. We can do it for red hearts now. Red hearts are much cheaper as far as deals with the devils are concerned than soul hearts. So we're good on that. We are okay now. So 3 HP, 2 soul hearts, we've got Miter, we've got great damage for where we are, great movement speed, a fantastic passive and PhD. We're sold now. We're solid gold. Whew, that was a bit of a clench there, especially in the cornfly room, man. I hate those things. I really do hate those things. I don't know why, like, for some reason, the yellow flies in particular have been pretty tenacious when it came to, when it comes to damage lately. And again, I'm not exactly sure why. We're going to be fighting Brownie Dingle. Which, again, this would have been an absolutely night. Whoa! There. I don't know where they came from. This would have been absolute nightmarish to go up against with only 1 HP. Thankfully, again, we've got it all sorted now. I've never actually seen that attack from Brownie Dingle go like that. I've never seen him spit out random turdlings like that. Like that. He seems to be firing them out at kind of random intervals. It's a little bit scary, to be honest. Right, we end up getting Magic Mush too. Okay, so now this is definitely... I feel like this is a blessed run at this point, because, man, getting Magic Mush out of nowhere. You know what? Let's just go down the next floor. Locked in deal with the devil. We got Goat Head, which, of course, is going to give us more deals with the devil. Sacrificial Dagger is fantastic. And more importantly, we got Magic Mushroom, which is going to act as our all stats up damage multiplier. Basically, literally God tier item. There's no, under no circumstances should you ever not take Magic Mush, I feel. I really cannot think of any circumstance where you would want to take Magic Mush, even if you have permanent polar and invincibility. The amount of damage of damage multiplying that you get from it is just, it's so good. Like, And obviously, you know, it's the best one. It's the best all stats up in the game too. Let's not forget about that. So we'll go into a curse room here. We don't have any guppy items yet, but we are going to profit at least one soul heart out of there. And especially coming from now that we've, you know, now of course that I've got a lot of new subscribers here from NL. Which first off, thank you by the way for allowing me to show you how I do content around here and checking out some of my content on YouTube. I do appreciate it. And secondly, now that I'm starting to get a lot of NL's fans over here. It's funny because we're now back into the whole soul heart versus spirit heart conversation, and. It is, and I've been getting people asking me, well, how can we call it Soul Hearts? The reason why I call it Soul, I used to, let me back up. So, a backstory on the Spirit Heart, Soul Heart controversy, which is not even a controversy, but let's just say it is anyway for hilarity's sake, is I used to actually call them Spirit Hearts, and that was from me being an NL fan and watching NL since Vanilla, and I'm talking about original Isaac, not Vanilla Rebirth, by the way. I got in the habit of calling them Spirit Hearts, because that's what he says. It was only after watching Lethal Frag, who was another friend of mine, where I discovered that, no, actually, the correct term for them is actually Soul Heart. That's what they are officially known as in the game. And so I started doing that. And obviously, you know, with NL being as prominent as he is, a lot of people were thinking that, you know, I was actually calling it wrong, and in reality, the game officially lists them as Soul Hearts, so that's why I made the switch. Every now and then, I'll kind of slip up and call them Spirit Hearts, and I don't feel bad about it, and I certainly am not going to pass judgment on anyone who wants to call them, you know, the adopted name of Spirit Hearts, but I personally, I like to call things for, you know, what they are, especially for newer players. Wow, that was some just god-awful damage. Just in case, you know, I feel like it's a little bit responsible to say, hey, you know, by the way, this is actually what it's called, not like something else. And again, I'm not passing judgment, I'm just saying. Yeah, we'll take little baggy, we might as well. Again, we do have PhDs, so I don't feel bad about that. I would like to get the soul heart. Now, we have taken quite a few shots of not great damage, and I can't say I'm a huge fan of it, but I'm not going to take that tarot card there. Obviously, we're not going to take one that makes you larger because, well, it's just distracting. And we already have a slightly bigger Isaac anyway, thanks to Magic Mush, so. And Sack Dagger showing you why it's top tier as far as the orbitals go. I love Sack Dagger. All right, now the Stain is going to be a little bit trickier to hit with the Sack Dagger. So we're going to have to rely on tier damage here. And we've already taken the deal with the devil. Or we've already been in the room, I should say, because we ended up fighting Krampus. We absolutely wrecked him with the Sack Dagger. I got a little bit greedy there. Cat of Nine Tails, fantastic item. And, yeah. Again, we just got done doing Krampus, so we're going to head down the next floor. We're in a solid position right now for what a comeback. I mean, Hail Mary is definitely going to be the title of this episode. And if you're one of those more interesting people, that's a nice way of me saying weird, who likes to skip through like halfway, like you skip the early stages here, you're not going to understand why this episode was called Hail Mary. But I promise you, if you watch the first like 3 or 4 minutes of this episode, you're going to know why. And it was an amazing turnaround. Let's say that it was almost euphoric in a way. I'm just looking for pills here, not really obviously looking for magic mush because we already have it. Liberty Cap, good. We actually have the double magic mush proc in here right now, as you see this size of Isaac's enormous forehead. I don't believe that the temporary magic mush multiplier stacks with the real magic mush. The temporary one being from Liberty Cap, by the way. Liberty Cap will duplicate. We'll randomly duplicate mushroom effects every now and then. It will also sometimes give you the compass effect for some unknown reason. Which, to my knowledge, there's no mushroom item in the game that that does something like that. So, I guess the only thing that's even close to that would be, like, you know, I Can See Forever, but that was only recently added in Rebirth. So, all right, looks like we proc'd. We actually proc'd us, I think, Skinny Odd Mushroom in here. It's definitely not Mini Mush. It might be Mini Mush. It feels like Skinny Odd Mushroom. Skinny Odd Mushroom is fantastic, by the way. So we're gonna get a little Chad, which is not the greatest here. And Guppy's Tail and two Soul Hearts, which is great. Now, something that has recently come up as far as Guppy's Tail goes, and we keep seeing Guppy's Tail more and more often for whatever reason, is, of course, the fact that Guppy's Tail will cause more chests to drop, but it also reduces the amount of keys that naturally drop. So you have to find a way to counteract the effects of the lack of key drops with Guppy's Tail. And obviously, if you're lucky enough, you'll just spawn a bunch of iron chests, which are gray chests, and hopefully you'll do that. Or you can just get a golden key. I mean, that's that's fine, too, I guess. I'm not going to look a gift horse in the mouse or in the mouse or in the mouth. I don't know why a gifted horse would have a mouse, but I'm not gonna start judging. I'm gonna let the gifted horses do whatever they think is right, whatever they feel good. It's a living in a modern society now where, you know, gift horses, they wanna have mice, they can. Who am I to tell them that they can't have one? So I did see on Liberty Cap that there is a, I believe that there is a vault on this room. Or on this floor. This might be a library, too, actually. I think it actually was a library and not a vault. And again, thankfully, we do have a golden key. So this will allow us to get in here no matter what. And it is going to be an actual shop, which is fine by me. I actually didn't want to pick that up, Isaac, but thanks. So I'm trying to get the compass. The compass would be great. Blue candle, you could make a case for it. But I would argue we probably... Yeah, take that key. I would argue that we probably don't need it now, especially with the amount of damage that we can deal. Glad I walked right into that. Maybe if we were still on 1 HP, I would possibly consider entertaining the idea, but yeah. We're gonna go with Book of Shadows here. I know this isn't the Book of Shadows, this is the Book of Sin, Victa. But Book of Shadows is great. It gives us a lot of opportunities for not only having an oh crap moment, but also getting some really quality damage in there with the Sack Dagger. If we hurry, we could probably make Boss Rush if we really, really wanted to. Oh yeah, we might as well. So, Book of Shadows, by the way, is just temporary invincibility like this. And just show you what kind of damage the Sack Dagger can do is just right there. I just walked by Chubb, and I barely even scratched him, and he's already halfway dead. Sack Dagger is definitely top tier, and again, we still have Mitre, so Mitre's going to back us up. If we end up getting Dark Bum, which, I mean, honestly, we have a pretty decent shot at getting Dark Bum, though. We have the little Chad Dark Bum Wombo combo, the dream, and that's what it's all about right there. So we are still getting keys, which is actually surprising, and I'm happy about that. I do want to go back and get the compass. This will just speed things up a little bit. Not that I'm in a hurry or anything, but if we want to, Boss Rush is still doable. We'd have to really book it, but we could do Boss Rush. Hush is definitely doable. Whether or not I actually want to fight Hush is a whole other story. Thank you, map, for blocking that. I appreciate that. So the mini-map blocked my view of that spike, apparently. And, alright. I'm starting to get into the impression that Super Secret Rooms really just are not worth it. I haven't found a good super secret room in a long, long time. Alright, so there's a dice room in here. And do we even go all the way down there? I don't think so if we want to try to make Boss Rush. I'm not that motivated to get Boss Rush done right now because we don't... We could do it. It wouldn't be safe, but again, with the Book of Shadows and Sack Dagger, we do have a pretty good chance of doing it regardless. I prefer to take the safer route right now and just simply get a teleportation card and just get the heck on out of there. Now, obviously, given the fact that we do have little baggy, that's going to be a little hard to get tarot cards because they're all going to turn to pills. But if we get a telepills, obviously we've got PhD, so we can at least identify them. I got stuck on a skull. So, Thunder Thigh is not really what I'm looking for. If we still only had 1 HP at this point, I don't think we would have lived. But if we did, I would have taken Thunder Thighs, only for the sole purpose of just having more HP. But, like, extra HP is not worth the stompy effect and, more importantly, the speed downgrade. Speed was basically our biggest factor in surviving there. Other than the fact that we got, of course, the Hail Mary Balls of Steel pill, which is Still, I got like nerd chills over, man. It was beautiful. I can honestly say that that probably won't happen again. I'm just being a realist. It would be nice if that sort of luck, you know, happened to persist throughout many different Isaac runs. But obviously, we know that Troll Engine is not always on point like that. Wow, that was the fastest. That was the fastest psychic shot from a pink shot, a pink fire I've ever seen. And yeah, then we're just gonna get hit again. And even more amazingly, we didn't actually destroy the purple fire. So that's good. That was really, really good. Mom's bottle of pills. We can't afford, so we don't have any bombs. I'm surprised that we're getting this many key drops, though, given the fact that we do have Guppy's tail. Magic Mush is actually providing a little bit of an issue right now with our with me being able to see where damage is coming from. So do we re-roll this run if we had a chance? Maybe. We don't have a winning run right now. Yeah, I'm definitely popping the Book of Shadows against Brownie. It's just not even a question. Okay, growth hormone, speed and damage, of course, is amazing. And we get a Fame. No, that's Maul of the Void. And the Razor Blade, which we obviously don't want. So Maul of the Void. Yeah, Boss Rush, by the way, is not happening. Maul of the Void will give us a black ring of death, pretty much, that we can cast around Isaac. Now, the beauty thing about Maul of the Void is that it does give you a very high chance at getting an evil soul heart or a black soul heart. If by you killing stuff with the black ring of Maul of the Void. Now, the trade-off for that, of course, is that you have to get in close and deal damage. And especially if you take terrible damage like that. It is possible that you put yourself in kind of a risk. That's another ball is a steel pill, and I will happily take it, because we've been taking a lot of really, really, really bad damage. I mean, I guess I'll take Abel just so he doesn't show up again. Very, very thankful that we do have growth hormones for our health up. Yeah. I'll go see what this dice room is. It could be a 5 room, which would re-roll our floor, which is basically forget me now. 2 full charges there is nice. The damage that Maw of the Void does is directly tied to your tier damage, by the way. Much like Brimstone. It's basically a temporary Brimstone that you have plus Tiny Planet without all the badness. There's a Tinted Rock here, which I will go take. Although we don't have a bomb, so I'm not quite sure how I'm supposed to get that. And yeah, that was pretty cool. Okay. It's a 4 room. The 4 room is, I believe, a global D6, I want to say. You know what? Speed up. Okay. Speed. I believe this is a global D6. I don't believe it also rerolls the shop. I think it only does item pedestals. There we go. We finally get an evil heart. I wouldn't mind playing that blood bank, especially given the fact that we do have. Let's go. We could go possibly get another HP here. Let's see what these pills are. Speed up again. Speed up. Okay, our movement speed might be a little bit ridiculous now. I like movement speed. Don't get me wrong, but there is such thing as too much movement speed, and I've actually demonstrated that before on my channel. If Isaac actually moves too fast, he carries through some weird momentum that goes through the door that he passes through, to the point where you'll actually catch him moving from a previous room, and then you'll run like straight to spikes, or for example that as well. So I'm not a huge fan of too much movement speed. Although yeah, I didn't have to take those pills either. Yeah, so there we go. It rerolled that. I guess I'll take. I usually don't take punching bag, but whatever. We could take the starter deck, or the deck of cards rather, but I don't think it's really worth it. So we have a mini boss down here, and it's gonna be Wrath, which is good because we actually need bombs really bad. There's a tinted rock in here as well. And we didn't get a bomb. I mean, technically, I guess we did, but it's not exactly what I wanted. It's not what I had in mind when I said we needed a bomb. Can't get into the boss trap room. It's gonna be a little chub. Is it worth using the Book of Shadows to protect half of a soul heart? I would say so. So we just got another Balls of Steel pill. Hematemesis. Speed up. I will use that to shed our red heart, and then this will allow us to get into the boss trap room, which has four golden chests. Which I don't have any bombs to open with, but I guess I'll take one. It's a paralysis pill, which is super. So we're back down to having no keys again. Not low key, but no key. There's no key like low key. And we have, thank you, Gimpy. And yeah, thank you, Monstro. We have kind of a high motivation to get in bosses' faces, but more particularly bosses that will spawn adds, because again, we want to have as many opportunities to spawn an evil soul heart with the Maw of the Void as much as possible. But I mean, I didn't actually mean to do that. We're obviously sorted now as far as HP is concerned. I'm not a huge fan of the amount of dumb damage we're taking, but that's not really the product of the game, more so as me just being awful. It would be nice to get the Leviathan transformation, at least for flying. Obviously, Guppy would be amazing as well. Speaking of amazing, look at that. It's pretty good. So I would probably call this one a one run at this point. I did hear a key drop. There we go. Okay, so I'm going to use the key to get into the item room. And then we have a game kid, which I'm not eager about, but I will use it but to at least touch it here. And a little Gertie, no thank you. Charm the Vampire, Blue Hourglass. Dr. Fetus again? No. That might disappoint some people, but we just got done having a... Yeah, I'll take Seraphim. We just got done having a Dr. Fetus run, and... far be it for me to be too samey with Eden runs here. I mean, I love Dr. Fetus, don't get me wrong. It's one of my favorite items in the game. But I don't think we need it to win this run. If we were in a kind of a dire straight situation, then I definitely would be a little bit more motivated to pick up one of the best carry items in the game. But this time around, I don't really feel the need. We really need keys. Guppy's tail has completely sapped our ability to get keys right now. We're making some amazing gains here as far as HP is concerned. And right there is the reason why I don't like Scapegoat, is because of that. It makes the pathing of the mobs very, very erratic and unpredictable. And in the world of Isaac, that is a very bad thing. You need to be able to know... You need to know what type of normal activities these monsters go through every day. I mean, I don't really care what they do in their everyday lives. Just whenever I fight, whenever I show up to kill them, I need to know that, hey, by the way, we're not doing anything new. I'm just doing the standard old attack pattern. Don't even worry about it. I'm like, okay, cool. Then we high five. So again, I'm highly motivated here to play this blood bank for not the reason that we need HP, but actually because I want to buy keys. And I want to just get more keys. That's about it. I'm a little bit sad that we don't have a 3-Skull Monty in here. We've had enough luck upgrades where we should be okay as far as our drops are concerned from a slot machine. Although, this is kind of begging to the contrary here. It's a little bit of a waste of a soul heart there, but that's okay. I'm going to go pretty hard on this. Look, all I want is a couple of keys here, game. Okay, yeah. Remember when I said I wanted some keys? This is not keys. All right. Well, that was a lot of fun. Thank you, slot machine. I appreciate that. Not only did we not get keys, we also didn't get any bombs. Which just makes that whole transaction even way worse than it was All right. Well, we're just gonna skip all those chests in the boss trap room that we fought through, and just go straight to the boss, I guess. I think we'll just fly through the rest of this run. Not really looking to min-max at this point. I mean, we've got a very, very nice one run here. Is this a hush killing run? Probably not. Guppy's Hairball and Betrayal. I'll take Guppy's Hairball. I don't want Betrayal. So we're 2 or 3 Guppy. We know that we're going to get at least 2 more deals with the devil. Again, the compass effect is very, very nice to have. The compass period is nice to have. It's a good infested pill there. Bad damage. Really, really awful damage. I'm getting a little bit sloppy with these dodges here, but to my credit, we are pretty amazingly fast right now. In my defense, not credit. And the movement speed, the increased movement speed is, again, obviously a problem. Sorry about that. So, yeah. Maw the Void. Ah, come on, little Chad, don't give me like that. Actually, I'm gonna use a Book of Shadows here just because I usually get tagged by one of those Brimstone Eye Lasers. I'm actually surprised at how little bombs have been dropping in this run. It makes me kind of a little bit sad that I didn't take Dr. Fetus, but what can you do? Again, given the fact that we do have Mitre and Maw of the Void, we really shouldn't have HP issues, regardless of how sloppy I get with it. But again, no bombs for us to partake. I actually kind of wish that I had a bomb, because I'd be super lazy and just bomb my way out of this, but we're just going to have to fight through it, and that's fine. Alright, we got a key. I'm gonna start hoarding keys now as we get closer and closer to the chest. And if you're wondering what exactly, how do you know when the Maw of the Void is ready to be triggered, you'll see a bright red inverted cross in the middle of Isaac's forehead. That represents that Maw of the Void is charged, and then you can go ahead and let it rip. I was expecting Pin to be in the middle there, I don't know why. I'm not sure why Pin wasn't there, but that's okay. Not sure what to think of this room right now. For a tinted rock, we don't have any. Even if we did, we don't have any bombs for it, so joke's on me, I guess. Alright, let's just do this song and dance. There we go. Just gonna use again Book of Shadows. There's no real reason to threaten any of our soul hearts here. And again, with Sack Dagger, we just laugh at it all. And Death's Touch, obviously top tier. I'm not gonna take Headless Baby just because I just don't like it. So Death's Touch, top tier item, as everyone knows. You wanna take Death's Touch. It's one of those you don't not take it. We are very sorted now on this run. With the amount of range that we have, the amount of damage that we've got, now that we have piercing, and the damage up from Death Touch, including the multiplier from Magic Mush, we are sitting pretty. And even with that said, I still don't feel like we have a Hush. I could beat Hush with this build, I just don't want to. Even if we still had like the opportunity to go to Hush, I still wouldn't go there, just because of the simple fact that it's an unnecessary risk, and we also don't have a whole lot of money or keys to be spending, so that kind of factors into my decision to not fight Hush either. On top of the simple fact that, of course, we're out of time. Okay, this whole like back and forth dipping that you Dingles are doing. By Dingles, I mean you Diglets are doing has got to stop. I'm not a fan of it. I'm tired of these MLG tryhard like Diglets, man. They're ridiculous. They're ridiculous. Or something like that. Yeah, where were you, Three Skull Monty, on the other time we were looking for you, man? We need some keys, bro. I'll go down to like 15 cents here. Just want to see if we can get like maybe one semblance of a bomb. Hey, we got keys. Why am I looking for a bomb? Because I would like to tap a tinted rock if we could. All right. There you go. Fair enough. Wow, that was a really fast shot there from the doppelganger, Isaac. We got another bomb. Alright, forgot what those look like, but... we got a boss trap room here, and... again! You know what? Sure, why not? So Tammy's head... just screwed us. Also, Tammy's head, Death's Touch, is fantastic. But, we didn't get a chance to use Book of Shadows because I accidentally walked over Tammy's head, and then that was pretty much it. Now, yes, I do, by the way, I do realize that I passed up the Sad Bombs Dr. Fetus combo. That has not been lost on me. Again, I would still argue that the reason why I didn't is simply because that's like, we just got done. Maybe if we didn't just get done doing another Dr. Fetus run, like, I probably would have taken it. Especially given the fact that it would have been the Sad Bomb's dream combo, but I think we're still okay. And, of course, Tammy's head is, again, top-tier carry item. Number one spacebar item by far. And I'm not joking. I'm not being facetious at all. If you have Brimstone or Death's Touch with decent damage... Tammy's head is the hardest carry item in the entire game, bar none, by far. I mean, by literal far here. I'm going to take the left hand here just in hopes of us getting just finishing the Guppy transformation. A couple people were kind of really... yeah, I'd like Mom's Knife. I would. But I'm not going to take it. Mom's Knife actually hurts Tammy's head. But anyway, some people looked at me weird like when I said that, because it's like how can you even say that? Apparently they're Stallone. They're like, how can you even say that? You know, it's like Tammy's head's good, but it's not that good. I think it is. You literally walk into any room, if you have decent damage, and you just simply hit the space bar, and then that's it. Like, there's no if, and, or buts about it. That's just how it goes. And Tammy's head allows you to do that to pretty much anyone in the game, except for major bosses. Major bosses, by the way, was my drill sergeant in the fake army that I didn't go to. Pretty fly, and balls of speed. I'm not taking the speed up. I still am going to hold on to the left hand, just hoping that we end up getting a Guppy transformation. It would be nice. See, that was double polycephalus, and that they went the way of the dodo. Yeah, I appreciate all these one that makes you larger pills game. I really do, but I don't want it. Wow. So right there was exactly what I was talking about with the whole momentum thing. I've got it on camera now. Isaac floated through the door because he moves too fast, and we ran right into that first eye. And if that would have been the end of the run, I would have been obviously extremely salty. But luckily, it's not. Oh man, this run has been a run of extremes. Actually, surprised that Death lived through that. Even more surprised that we didn't hit him at all with Tammy's head. Now, is the game going to punish me for not taking the gifted Sad Bombs Dr. Fetus Wombo combo? Probably. I think that we'll still be okay. We have taken a lot of damage. It's not over yet. Yeah, this is Scapegoat kind of doing its thing. And again, I can't stress to you how bad that is. There's a reason why I don't like having too much movement speed, and I have no one to blame but myself. By the way, I want to emphasize that I'm the one who took the speed up pills. The game didn't force it, but that needs to stop. We need to stop walking to doors and having Isaac keep continually walking, even though I've told him not to. To hear a key press, it's me trying to correct the trajectory of Isaac there before he walks into anything else. That was a terrible Tammy's head. We missed everything. Obviously, ideally you'd want Tammy's head in like spectral tears. Like that's the best for Death Touch. But I'm not gonna be greedy though. This is a far cry from where we were like 30 minutes ago. There we go. It's weird that only seems to affect only half of the Headless Horseman. Like we one-shot the bicycle helmet, but for some reason his bottom half was not affected. Gonna try to get a little bit greedy with the with Maw in the Void here. Staying away from Scapegoat is the best idea. Honestly, our tier damage isn't the greatest. It's not bad, of course, but it's not as high as you would think it would be with the given the amount of like premier prestige items that we've got. It's still good enough to win, though. That's all that matters for me. So it's looking like we're gonna hit 20 here on the streak. Curse of the Unknown's a little bit scary. I forgot to drop the left hand. We end up getting the pentagram though, which is gonna give us more damage. And we did not get Guppy. All right, so a little sad about that. I could theoretically still go with the left hand. We are gonna get a third orbital, which is nice. Well, we've already had a third orbital, but. I'm really sad that we didn't get Guppy on here. We had a good chance. Again, not knowing how much HP we have though is a little bit of a scary proposition. I know that we lost one on the pentagram trade. We traded three and got back two, so. Fine. Getting a couple soul hearts here is going to be hopefully be our top prerogative here. Top priority, I should say. Not prerogative. These one that make you larger pills, man. I don't know. I'm not sure who decided like I was going to need or want any of these on this run, but I would have preferred those be like, you know, more balls of steel pills, but hey, we've been given everything that we needed on this run to win. So There's nothing else to do on this run except just to win. And I'm actually pretty happy that we have this power pill just because it does give us the option to do as much damage to Blue Baby as possible before using it. Or we could also exercise the option of just charging on in and just killing him immediately. So we got health up. Obviously, I'm not going to take that. And let's just go fight Blue Baby here. I'm actually going to use the power pill now. And we're going to try to get as much damage as we can with Sack Dagger on him. Sack Dagger brought him to about 10%. And the Maw of the Void should finish him off. There we go. Very enjoyable run. That was an amazing run. And again, with the Hail Mary, that's one of the luckiest things I've seen in Isaac in a very long time. Thank you for watching, everyone. Do appreciate the support. Welcome all new subscribers. If you're interested in supporting me other ways, you can check out my Patreon. Patreon.com/Invicted. It helps a great deal. Until next time, our 20 streak continues. Will it continue after that? Who knows? But until next time, so long, everybody!